What kind of plants do you use for the native gardens?
Generally, we use native plants almost exclusively. Part of our rules with our kosher here is we have to use native vegetation. Not to say you can't put your own in. We base everything off of native, but you can add some perennials. I mean, you can add some other things in here to the gardens that you like, but the basics of the garden has to be native.
When you pick the plants, do you try to pick plants that are going to be nice throughout the growing season?
We do. There's a lot that goes into picking the plants. You know, we consult with the homeowner a lot. We have some books that give them ideas of, you know, colors and different things. Obviously, different plants go in the bottom of the garden where it could be wet for a short period of time versus what I would call the upland portion of the garden that is dry most of the time. We do pick different plants based on color. Based on timing of the year, you know, they bloom at different times. Based on height, a lot of times, you know, you put your taller plants towards the back so they don't overshadow the smaller ones in the front.
Well, I'm looking behind you, and there's actually some grasses included in this planting too. Why do you use grasses and flowers?
Okay, well, the native grasses, like I said, they have a really deep root system. So they're the big nutrient grabbers. I mean, those roots go deep, and we use a lot of natives, you know, the Indian grass, the blue stems, the switch grasses, you know, they'll get down to almost 12 feet deep with their roots. The forbs don't go quite as deep in a lot of cases. So the grasses are there to kind of shore up the soil and grab those nutrients, you know, before they run off.
And I'll bet you that they add a lot of beautiful fall color too.
They do. A lot of these grasses look really nice. The blue stems, I mean, they're bright red, and, you know, it just adds another aspect to the garden, to the beauty of the garden.
Can you use shrubs in a rain garden too?
You can use some shrubs. Yep, people do use some shrubs. A little bit limited because the shrubs tend to get overgrown. You know, there's a lot of trimming involved with that because a shrub over time, I mean, you leave a shrub in for 10 years, it's going to be pretty good size and it'll choke out a lot of other things. So unless you have a really unique situation or a really big garden, we don't do a lot of shrubs, but you can.
Are there any city ordinances that you have to worry about as far as height when you're planting a rain garden?
You know, we don't really run into any problems with city ordinances. We keep everything kind of back out of the right of way so it's not impeding anybody's view. You know, they're up against, most of the time up against the house, and you know, it's in a controlled garden situation. You know, it's not like a lawn that, you know, there's some height regulations. So, you know, it's in a controlled area, so we don't have any problems. And we've done a lot of projects with the city, so we're educating them on the benefits of native plants.
Is there an optimum time of when you should or can plant a rain garden?
You know, we've done them from spring to fall. It really doesn't make a lot of difference. All these plants, and another good reason for using native plants is they're very hardy. I mean, you think about these plants, in most cases are out on the prairie. You know, they survive winter, fall, drought, rain, everything. So we've planted a lot of plants even in a dormant stage in the fall, you know, no problems with them coming back in the spring because they're that hardy, and, you know, they're meant to be outside in an unprotected climate.